Welcome back. Then, as we were telling you, a bit of a recovery is what we are seeing on the screen. So that's good news, but it's results season. So let's get chatting with the management. As promised, KC International is the management that we're talking about. Remember, they posted a rather good set of numbers in the second quarter, margin expansion. That's the one that drove really the profit beat. We're currently joined by Mr. Vimal Kejriwal, the MD and CEO of the company who joins in. Hi, Mr. Kejriwal. Always a pleasure, sir, talking to you. Well, the revenue in the T&D business, that's declined. Is this owing to GST? Will the impact carry forward to the second half of the year?
The revenues have declined mainly because of GST. If you look at what we have talked about, there's a 5% impact on the GST on our revenues. So now that the orders are coming in, the numbers would be back to normal, I think, by Q4.
Right. Sir, you had hinted in your press release that you're confident of achieving the earlier targets. So would you stick to your 15% revenue growth guidance for FY18? I mean, the only reason I ask is because in H1, it's just been 3%. So will you be able to make good the rest in H2?
See, the H1 growth 3% is, when you are comparing the numbers. If you compare like to like, the growth is much more than that because the GST impact is not factored into these numbers. But overall, I think we are still pretty confident that we should be able to stick to our numbers of 15%.
Okay, let's talk about a couple of positives then, sir. You know, margins are really healthy at around that 10% odd mark. Is this sustainable? What kind of a number can we work with for the full year in terms of margins? Is 10 to 12% on the cards?
No, I don't think we can go to 12%. We have been talking about 9.5, etc. For the half year, we are at 9.7. And for the quarter, it has been 10.1. So I think we should be able to maintain around 10% for the year.
Okay. So the railway business has shown good traction. It's about 80-odd percent, on a year-on-year basis. Is this performance sustainable or is it just because of the low base?
So railway business, even in our earlier interviews, we have been talking about, almost doubling our revenue year-on-year. So the last 2 years, we have doubled. This year, we are around 80%. So we are pretty confident that we should be able to maintain. See, our railway order book is close to 1400 crores. And post-GST, there have been a lot of new tenders which have been announced. I think almost 6,000 crores of tenders are where we have already quoted. So we are very clear that railways, business will grow.
Well, Mr. Kejriwal, the net debt, it appears that it's up by around 500 crores in the last 6 months. The receivable days also have deteriorated a tad bit. Why is this? What's the outlook on the same?
See, the basic reason, again, I'll come back to GST, because what happened was that most of the state utilities and PGCIL took their time to, amend the contracts, etc., to enable us to dispatch and to bill. So, which is the basic reason why the billings got delayed. So, the billings have now all happened, which is why it's reflected in the revenue, and now we'll start getting the collections. So, I'm not unduly worried about this. This, to me, is a blip which will get corrected now.
All right, Mr. Kejriwal, sir, we'll leave it at that. Thanks very much for your time this afternoon. So that's the word coming in from KEC International, hoping to maintain margins at around the 10% mark in FY18. Clarifying also that like-to-like, the growth for the first half was way better than the 3% mark, which has been reported. With that, let's just focus then to the key earnings, which are expected today and from the frontliners.